Nice to be here, and thank you for my favorite music as well. So I'm Joni from FirstBeat, and what we do is we analyze heartbeat for different kind of applications and services. And our headquarters is in Finland, and so it's actually the temperatures are now quite similar to San Francisco over there. But our favorite sport in Finland is ice hockey, not basketball, but that's for several reasons. Okay, so we do heartbeat analytics for different markets, and one is the elite sports or professional sports market, where we do work with about 600 teams around the world. It's NBA, it's also NHL, European soccer, also a little bit of NFL and rugby, different sports. And so obviously we like to mention some of the teams that are doing well, and so there's a very good reason to name the Warriors as one example, and I will tell more about them, I don't think we work with Cleveland, so that's that should be good. And other market we are working is consumer products markets, where we basically license our technology to be embedded into different market, in the products. And there's about 60 different consumer products in the market today that deploy FirstBeat technology to make sense of the raw data, to make it more useful for the consumers. Third one we have been gathering and learning has been preventive healthcare, where we have worked mainly in a corporate healthcare, corporate wellness, with the different service providers, and that would be mainly in Northern Europe, in UK and in Scandinavia. And there we have experience with about 7,000 different corporations using this to change their lifestyles. Okay, so about our approach. We are a physiology-based company, and how we see that the physiology, that's the link between our lifestyle and the health consequences. It all goes to, a lot of that goes through physiology. And so it's very essential and key to have physiological references as a part of the development, and that's a very natural part of what we do. And so we are based in physiology research. We actually spin off from research, and we try to be quite open in how analytics works. And we have a bunch of white papers, research, and it's also used in about 80 different universities for research, and that creates a little bit more openness as well, how it works. So our heartbeat, there's a lot of changes in it. So at any given point, there's 15 to 20 different signals within it. And what we do is we decompose different components of it. There's heart rate variability, there's different reactions. So there's much more than just heart rate into the heartbeat. And out of those things that influence in our body processes that do influence our heartbeat, so we detect what is causing what in the heartbeat. And out of that information, we create a model, digital simulation model of your physiology. And once we know what's happening in the body, so we model respiratory system, energetic system, metabolic system, oxygen consumption, stress, autonomic nervous system. And once we know what's happening in the body, then we can actually tell you what's happening in the body in a more meaningful way. So if there's stress, what is the fitness level, and so on. And so basically, this kind of analytics is required to make the consumer wearables into the mainstream. And it is certainly required for making sense of that, for example, for healthcare purposes, as the information needs to be meaningful for the use. So raw signals don't make it. And so basically, that's how we work. And so one area is professional sports, where we have gathered a lot of experience at the front end of the competition. And so Warriors is one of the teams. We also work with the San Jose Sharks, but also unfortunately you can also find Pittsburgh there in the customer list. And how they use it? Basically, they use it to understand for each player what is the individual training status, what is the load, exercise load for each player, what is the recovery for each player. All players are different. And so it's about individualized training. A little bit like personalized medicine in a similar way. They're all players are individual. So I have this one particularly well-picked example of Warriors, and because we make these user stories, and you can find more long story from my website. But basically, the physical performance and sports medicine head of that, Mr. Penfold, indicates that as there are many, obviously there's many games in NBA, and they can be as much as 9 games in 14 days. So that's a lot of traveling. That's a lot of games, and there's a limited time for training and limited time for recovery. So basically, this is the area that our system is used in monitoring and trying to get the training schedules and recovery strategies as individualized as possible. And so basically working for each athlete, what is the best routine for each athlete to implement the training program and recovery strategies. And that may mean, for example, that during training, they have a little bit different, every athlete is doing a little bit different program, but that means that it's individualized. And basically finding out the routines for each athlete that helps them to enhance their performance. And eventually this leads to, for example, in reducing the number of injuries as the, all of the training is more individual. And this is one example. This is a Brazil football team there doing a recovery test before training, a quick screening to see and what's the distribution of the recovery status of each athlete. And if an athlete is in a red zone, they're showing a bad recovery, so that must need that is taken into account when training is planned for this athlete, as an example. Other one example is during training. So if the target there, for example, has been to have a moderate training effect for your aerobic fitness, so then you want to see that the athletes don't go too low, too far from it, they don't make it too hard, or that they don't make it too easy. And then, for example, the analytics help to understand what was the part of the exercise that improved your aerobic fitness and what was the anaerobic effect and so on. So making it more useful for the coach to make decisions based on the training. So what can we learn from the pro sports? Certainly we have learned that as a part of winning solution, there is individualized training in the background. So not every player in the team is the same. And so all athletes are individual, and that is actually very much related to the use of sensors there, because sensors are used to understand where each athlete is. And it's very similar to medicine or to consumer use of wearables. The good use of sensors is to personalize things for you, and that's really, and to get useful. So how to get useful? The coaches do need to be able to act on data. One thing is that following that things are going as they should be, as planned, or then using the physiological analytics as a proxy to guide the training in real time. Or if there's question marks, for example, in terms of recovery or let's say the performance capacity of any player, so taking that into more detailed follow-ups and acting on the data, so making decisions based on the data. So what does this mean then again? How to get actionable? Accuracy does matter, and that is one thing, and it's not that accuracy per se would be so, well, it is important, but if you want to rely on the data, so it must be valid enough to indicate what is happening there in the, for example, in the athlete's physiology and athlete's body. So there, it needs to be accurate enough and valid enough to be able to use it for the good reason. And otherwise, I mean, this is to really to take the luck out of the decisions, to make better informed decisions, not to, you know, throw dice. So that's why the accuracy does matter. Raw data is not particularly useful even for physical conditioning coaches. The data needs to be processed more close to the level that it's actually been used to make the decisions. So not raw data, but analytics to make sense of the data. And obviously, the coaches also need to understand the data And so it must be something that they would use in the training philosophy. And that, all that needs requires more and more analytics of the data, being able to make actions based on each player. So in the consumer markets, the same kind of dynamics are also prevalent there. So these are some examples that we provide for the consumer products, and fitness level is something, for example, you may find it in about 25-30 different consumer products. Basically tells automatically your fitness level based on heartbeat and some other data if you do any training. And I will explain you a little bit more of that later, why is it important for all of us and also for healthcare. Training effect indicates what was the result of any exercise for your aerobic fitness. And so basically it sums up what happened if you do any exercise. And we have accurate energy expenditure that automatically calibrates for your fitness level and all of your different dynamics in your body. As we know very well what's happening in your body if you just give us your heartbeat data through any of these sensors. So we can also advise what would be a good type of exercise for you, or maybe you shouldn't do exercise because you have done too much exercise. And so again, getting more personal, using the sensors to being able to provide more personal feedback on the data. Real-time guidance, we can provide real-time guidance within the device to help to make give exact right level of doses of exercise for your body. Again, given your past history and fitness condition and all of different conditions. And we can also advise to recover based on the data. It should how much recovery time there should be. So the fitness level actually improves when we recover, but there needs to be the exercise before that. It's not just just sleeping. It doesn't help alone, but sleeping is very helpful there. Physical activity score, so again, measuring heartbeat and through heart rate, we get to model the cardiovascular fitness and the effects of exercise to cardiovascular fitness. This helps to indicate what is the overall effect of exercise for your cardiovascular health. So it's a little bit further than more than steps, and it helps to translate what is the effect of exercise for cardiovascular health. Sleep recovery, again, based on heart rate variability and the ability of the body to recover at night, and we can also provide continuous stress recovery readings throughout the day in different 24-hour concepts, and I will show you some examples later. So basically, helping to link lifestyle and what is happening in lifestyle and different events to your body physiology, what happens, what's the reactions, which then relates to health. So fitness level. Certainly fitness level is important for athletes, for endurance athletes especially, and it can make the difference of whether you win in Olympics or if you win a game. It is also important if you want to improve your fitness. It sounds a little bit simple, but if you want to lose weight, you want to use the scale to measure if you get a result. In a similar way, if you want to get more fit, it's nice to get some feedback on whether you are getting more fit. It is also a basis for providing more personalized training guidance. What is the right type of exercise for you? And I'm bringing this up because there are many products in the category called fitness trackers, but they are not very well capable of tracking fitness, which is a little bit, it's a well-named segment, but they don't actually do what the segment tells. And so there's certainly some development there, and this is where adding heartbeat sensors helps in the market. Fitness level is also very much related to how you feel, feeling better. It is certainly related to productivity at work, and so there's wellness causes to and wellness reasons to get more fit. And if we look at health, so there are not, actually not very many conditions that wouldn't allow exercise. So there are only a few conditions that wouldn't allow exercise as a treatment. And there are some meta-analyses showing that that if you are in the lowest percentile of fitness, so increasing the fitness by 10% actually decreases the all-cause mortality risk by 15%, and that is a pretty good deal, actually. So fitness is very much related to the healthcare, and it is very much related how to dose exercise right for a person. So because, of course, we have very different backgrounds, we have very different capabilities, and so it's very important to personalize any advice for exercise, for example. So being able to show if you progress in fitness, as if it's going as intended, being able to provide predictions that are related to also to healthcare costs, and being able, and most importantly, being able to provide personalized advice on what would be good for you based on the data. So this is why we see that fitness is one of the very key elements that should be implemented in different ecosystems. So there's some examples of the 60 products that are in the market, and which do have some of these features. And just shortly, so there's a Garmin Forerunner 630. This was introduced in I think in October last year, and this does have a lot of features in it, which we enable. They're basically, so it has a lactate threshold, which is for running, very geared for running. It gives also the automated fitness level, training effect, stress scores, and so it's for running. This is another product, Samsung Gear Fit, which has a real-time guidance on your training, and it is a little bit more geared towards casual fitness. And it does also have the training effect. And there's Sony product, which is capable of monitoring real-time stress and recovery through the optical, and there's Microsoft product, which tells also about fitness level and training effect. So just some examples of a good product in the market for different different segments. Then the third area we have been working on, which is maybe the most exciting, is the preventive healthcare. And this, in this market, we have worked in the form of working with the healthcare providers, companies that provide healthcare for companies, basically. And so the product we have developed, the service, it's used as a part of health assessments, so basically annual health assessments. And this has been a very good living lab for us for developing understanding on how to make behavioral changes based on the data. Normally the employee would wear the device, monitoring device for a few days, and then out of that you get to identify things that cause stress. So when are you stressed, and understand what is causing stress, understand recovery, understand also sleep quality, and understand if the exercise is right for your fitness and your background. And so basically you get reports of stress, and when is the stress peaking, what is the balance, most importantly, what is the balance between stress and recovery. And so basically seeing data is for many, especially if it's engineers, executives, seeing data is very, that's the critical element of changing, and of course you make a change and then you see how the data is. And it's really about educating on the lifestyle and on the consequences of your lifestyle on your health. And this is another example there showing for example, starting point here, using resources basically, so stress and some recovery here, using resources, only a little bit of recovery at night, and then it's a little bit more bumpy, but Monday night is quite good actually, and then, yeah, he ends up quite well there. And again, this is used to educate people on the balance in their lifestyle, and it's just too much stress is too much stress, basically. And so the companies pay for this, and companies and insurance companies pay for this to save in healthcare costs and also be more productive. And this is one, for example, for Nuffield Health from UK, and basically, data. But of course, it's not just raw data, but really analyzing data to make more informed actions in your own lifestyle. So this is the use of this, and we have done about 200. So about 200,000 users have done this, and on overall, 96% of the persons would recommend this for others, which is very high percentage. One, why is it so high? One is that it's delivered through healthcare, and then there's always a professional user there. So it's actually a combination of technology and services. And this is one area we very much believe in. And of course, then this is where accuracy matters, because you want to provide some advice based on the data. But it's very good percentages. And also, in some cases, the companies have been able to save 50% in their healthcare costs. And about 82% has been able to change some aspect of their lifestyle after this. But again, it's a combination of technology and services, and so some very good results. But it's not something that you just throw away, give away. But it has the service element into it. And so this is some data, for example, we have gathered. And this is from Northern Europe, and the data is showing, for example, that if we monitor stress levels throughout the week, so on average, the stress levels the stress balance tends to decrease, so there's more stress and not so able to recover. The Saturday seems to be the worst on average, which is maybe bad to some really bad recovery strategies there on Friday night. And but Sundays are quite good, actually. But those who keep more fit, they have much better readings across the whole week than those who are physically more inactive. So lots of interesting data that we use for developing next generation products in the 200,000, so basically the customers, we have 200,000 customers that have come through coaching, and we have these discussions there, and so we are really using this data to understand and develop further how to use the data more effectively and analytics more effectively to change behaviors. I like to think that the 96%. So because of so high percentages of the users to recommend this for others, so I like to think of this as a proof that general people are really interested in health and then their own well-being and on the delivery, but it's a matter of how to deliver and it's a matter of approach there. And if it was only let's say consumer device without the service component, I don't think we would get even close to as that high percentages as working with the healthcare providers there. So, thank you.